Hey guys, we are going to continue working on percents. And this says, Taylor got a job after he graduated college. If he makes $2,500 a month after taxes, so after taxes is what we call our net income. Okay? This is after and gross income. Is before. Okay? I always think of it as like a net, like if you think of a fishing net draining out your taxes and you're left with what's left. Okay? So gross has all of the taxes in there. You don't get to see all of that money. Net income is actually what we call our take home pay after the taxes have been taken out. Okay? So this says, how much will he pay on debt repayment? So I know you can't see all this. This is a general budget, so this says housing, so this would be either your mortgage payment or your rent, transportation, that could be paying for a car, it could be gas, it could be car insurance, debt repayment, this might be school loans, credit card debt, things like that, savings, this is a good, something good that you should have, which is save 10% of what you make, and then we have this says life, so I'm thinking of this as like it could be stuff for medical, it might have life insurance, so this looks like 25% here, but this could be several different things, because I don't think life insurance would be that much. So, this says how much it will he have for debt repayment, okay? So, debt repayment, when I look at this, says 15%. So, remember yesterday, we talked about how you can change that percent to decimal and multiply. So normally when you have a budget, guys, that needs to be done on your net income. This represents my net income or Taylor's net income, okay? You don't want to make a budget on money you're never going to see, okay? You want to make it on what you actually have. So we can either take our 15%, change it to a decimal, and multiply. So that could be 2,500 times 0.15. The way I can do that proportion is over F equals percent over 100. My percent is 15%, guys. So this represents the debt repayment. So that means this will also be debt. I spelled that wrong. Debt repayment. Hopefully you know debt is something that you owe as opposed to like a debit card, which is a card that takes money out of your account. Okay, now we also know 2,500, guys, this is our total. In this case, it's the total that we have as far as our take-home pay, okay? Now, either way I solve this, I'm going to just cross-multiply it this time. I think it's a little bit longer, but just so that you have the practice. Either way, you should get the same answer, okay? So, I get 100x, and now I'm going to do 2,500 times 15. As you can tell, this is almost the same as what you're seeing right here, okay? But we don't have to deal with decimals. 0, 25, carry the 2. 5 times 2 is 10, plus 2 is 12. Okay, and then I need to do the second row. Hold my spot, and I always like to darken it so I don't mess it up with a zero here. 1 times 0, 0, 0, 5, 2, right? And it's a 1. 0, 0, 5, 2. And then we add 0, 0, 5, 7, 3. So I have 3, 7, 5, 0, 0. Okay, now I'm going to divide by 100, and when I divide by 100, guys, this is an easy one because I have zeros top and bottom, so I can either move my decimal around 2, dividing by 100 makes it smaller, or I can cross, okay? So this much of my budget, this is budgeted, okay, towards debt repayment. That's a lot of money, $375 a month. That might go to school loans or credit card debt. That can add up, Okay? Okay, so let's look at this one. This comes from a star test. Okay? Notice there's a lot of reading here, and there's actually quite a few numbers, so you're going to have to, like, read it carefully. Russell has a collection of 1,200 pennies. Of these pennies, 25% are dated before 1980, 35% are dated from 1980 to 2000, and it should say the rest are dated after 2000. Sorry about that, I didn't type it correctly. The rest are dated after 2000, okay? So how many pennies in Russell's collection are dated after 2000, okay? So there's a couple of ways we could do this. I think the harder way would be to say, I can take 1,200, this is just one way, times 0.25, change the percent to a decimal. That will tell me my pennies before 1980. And then I can do 1,200 and multiply by 0.35. And that's going to tell me my pennies from 1980 to 2000. And I would add those two numbers that you get, and I would subtract that from 1,200. Okay? Whatever I got. So I can do it that way. Or I can also say, okay, well, I have 25% and 35%. These are dated before 1980. These are dated from 1980 to 2000. And the rest are dated after. So if I want to add these, and I don't even think I've actually ever solved it this way, but I'm thinking right now that it's much easier. 60% are basically before 2000, right? This is before 1980, before, from 80 to 2000, right? So 60% are before, so that means 40%, 100%, take away 60%, is 40%. 40% then would be dated after 2000, okay? These are before 2000, these are after, okay? And again, please feel free to do it with whatever way makes most sense to you. And again, I don't think I've ever solved it this way. I'm just thinking about it now, and I think it might be easier, even though this way might be more logical, okay? So I have 1,200 total pennies, 40% are dated after 2000. 0, 0, 8, 4, and I'm going to move it one time. That's it. So 480 of those pennies are dated after 2000. And I'm just thinking about the reasonableness. 50% of this would be 600. Okay? When we have 40%, which is less than 600, this is less than 600. So, and again, this comes from a star question. So, and obviously, if this is multiple choice, that would be your answer like that. Sorry about that. But you see that? Please feel free to pause the video if you could not see it. Okay, now, this is a different one here, okay? This was not on star, but there was a star question similar to this, okay? Leah bought 3 lamps for her house. The tax on the total purchase was $6, so we know how much the tax was. 8% was tax, 8% tax was charged. Find the cost of 1 lamp before tax, okay? So this part right here is where we're going to mess up. We want the cost of 1 lamp, but we're starting with 3 lamps, okay? So this is when you cannot change the percent to a decimal and multiply. You cannot do that because this is not a total. This is the tax, okay? Now, the way I'm going to do it is, I'm going to say, okay, well, this is over of. I know for sure 8%, that is tax. And I know $6 is the tax. These two match up. They have to both be like equivalent. $6, 8% tax, okay? Now, what you can do is I could put 3x here, okay? Because officially there are three lamps, but that might confuse you. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put x here, and x is going to represent the cost of three lamps. If I was in algebra, I would probably put 3 here so I would remember at the end to do my last step, okay? So, 600 on one side, 8x on another side, on the other side, divide by 8, divide by 8, on both sides, okay, so remember if you don't know your 8s, 8, 16, 24, 32. I can't remember if I have to take this to a decimal or not, so I might need the space, but oh well. 56, 64 is too much, okay? So 8 won't go into 6. Make sure you have that there. 8 times 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is 56. Subtract, and you get 4. No, I won't have a decimal here. That's good. So 8 into 40, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So exactly $75, guys. So the cost of the three lamps is $75 for the three lamps. But this says find the cost of one lamp. So I'm hoping you're seeing this could easily trick you, okay? I'm going to tell you that they could do, that they would do something like change the percent to a decimal, and that would be an answer choice. 75 would be an answer choice, and that's not correct. This is the cost for three. Assume each lamp costs the same. So I'm going to do 75 divided by 3, and that will give me the cost of one lamp. 3 into 7, 2, 6, 1, 5, 3 times 5, 3 into 15 goes 5. Okay. Now, if you want to check, so we're going to put this right here, 25, and let's put a box around it. Now, if I want to double-check this, what I would do is I would say, okay, it's about three lamps. 25 times 3 is 75, so $75. And there's 8% tax, 0.08. 8 times 5 is 40, 24. 8 times 7 is 56. That number should sound familiar here. 56 plus 4 is 60. 1, 2, 1, 2. Well, 8%, and that was the tax. And guess what 6 was? 6 was the tax. So we did it correct. This is just kind of working backwards to make sure I did it correctly. But the cost of one lamp is $25. Okay, 3 lamps. Percent tax. Tax. Okay.